looking pretty solid, and Damwon Gaming need to battle back right now against the Afrika Freaks if they want to lock down.
Seeing Dread up top lane. Thing to consider, very easy to execute team comp from Afrika, which might benefit a young liner.
Well, this could also benefit Afrika as well, as Noggery's trying to get out. Good flash, but can he get the knock-up? Doesn't happen. Dread is going to miss it, but it doesn't matter. Just spins around and cuts his head off.
Trying to return to this top lane, not an EQ range right now. But Afrika have gone for easy to execute. And speaking of execution.
Yeah, we're going to get the knock-up this time as Keen comes on over. Crippling strikes there. Apprehend pulls him back. And Noggery, where are you going to go, mate? The Kingslayer ain't slaying any kings now.
Tell his teammates about what's happening, but can they do anything about it?
Well, Dredd's just going to be able to grab this one as the hook is going to land. Oh, see you later, Silas. And Noggery's going to do Noggery things and continue. Yeah, Shelly's going to be here, and UCal has the heroic entrance available. Won't actually have to use it. He's already here. Abyssal Voyage to come on over. Taunt doesn't find any joy as the Q is going to land, but the Gargoyle is not the target that they wanted as Noggery picks up the ult and throws in the heroic entrance there as well. UCal immediately knocked up and has to flash to get out of the way, but Noggery has to go golden to keep himself alive. Dread diving on forward. There's the hero's entrance coming in for Afrika Freaks this time. It's Showmaker darting in and around this fight, and UCal eventually does fall down. Dread gets the tribute, can make his way back in, but decides he doesn't want to as the Ash is popping off and aiming. Cannot do enough. Noggery with the god-tier team fight.
His summoners are down, and Afrika like fighting. How hard are we going?
Yeah, it's pretty hard. Going to come in, but Dread has to go golden in order to keep himself alive. That means that is going to be one of the ultimates not there, and now he's even dead as Keen in the front line, and that's not where he wants to be. Takes the lantern in order to get out, and UCal might just be the sacrificial lamb. Grabs one off the back end as the catfish is going to bite the dust, but Afrika Freak still running for the hills.
Cannot afford to lose even one more team fight. They push up here. He's Dread. He's almost dead already.
He dives on forward. The hero's entrance does eventually come on down, but they do have the great health. They've got the devour. Nuclear will get played back, but is it actually creating enough distance? Is Keen not going to get the ultimate as Nuclear is able to flash out of the way and go golden?
Now the
gap is going to be closed here as Aiming still dancing around this fight, but Noggery picks up the kill on the Gargoyle. Damwon Gaming trying to get what they can as Keen's diving in there, but Aiming is still alive. Well, not for long as there's the double distort.
For Showmaker, so that's a pretty nice start. Here's an ult.
Yeah, Arrow's going to land on the Canyon, and he went for the Hex Drinker. He didn't go for the QSS, and he's just straight up dead. Nuclear just delivered that kill as Noggery wants to come in and continue this fight. Dread going to have his ultimate pulled away from him. Cataclysm available for Noggery, who is going to go golden because he has that Zhonya's still available to himself. Chains landed, and UCal is once again.
And Nuclear start the fights, which is all they need.
Yeah, 6,000 gold is now the lead, and the Baron has been started up. It is down very, very low, but Dread is going to pull his way forward. They do know that he's around here, and Keen is going to get over that well, but Dread just has no health, and Noggery's going to finish that one off. One of the chains.
Required to have pretty low cooldowns. That's already Aiming.
Yeah, Aiming's got hit by another one, and Nuclear just picks it up. Jelly flies on forward, but that Fate's Call is not the fate that you wanted. Flashes over the wall of the box and picks up the double, and now the Afrika Freaks are just flying towards a quadra kill for the Ash. Dread gets onto the fountain, and Damwon Gaming say, if you're not going to give me the Penta, then I'm just going to end the game.
Nuclear does his best Prey impression, brings back the frontline Ash, and it works so well.
Kane, what was that? We're looking for the Quadra, we don't get it. It's going to be Silas that denies that kill, and it's just a little flag that comes down from Prince Jarvan, and the Nexus explodes.
But it's not a little result for two teams short on confidence. Big win for Damwon Gaming in game number one.
We're Atlas and Papa Smithy, and we have a game two on our hands between Afrika Freaks and Damwon Gaming with... We'll see whether his over-aggression is still going to be his biggest Achilles heel as he goes aggressive once again onto Keen. Keen doing a fair bit of damage here, Corrupting Potion with that Time Warp Tonic keeping him alive for the moment, but if there's going to be a Shock Blast landing, Q's in there from Punch, and he's going to take the northern way out in order to keep himself alive against Spirit. The Predator has been popped though, and Noggery down beneath 100 health. Could that be two kills? The Spirit says nope.
Pia would just cleanse there to stop damage top lane.
Yeah, Keen has hit that level 6. Noggery doesn't have it just yet, but he's chased. It doesn't matter, and that's the Fear Beyond Death, and Keen gets the kill back.
If I'm trying to separate Noggery and Keen in a tier list.
Yeah, absolutely, and I think that he played beyond his years. There's the kickback as the Urgot is going to be delivered. And yes, we might have been singing his praises, but what can you do 2v1? The answer is not a whole lot. Spirit, can you do it again as he throws down the barrel? Doesn't quite find it onto Punch, and the wards are there, but it doesn't seem to matter. Punch is just going to wander on out. ADCS, that's where you're talking about disaster striking.
But you know what's one way to get him over? The timing's being a bit off. Let's go top lane and get a completed turret. It's going to die on this charge. You're going to get the final two plates. The Infernal's going to try to be the answer. There's not really any pokes, so surely you have to give this up, is my first thought. Can Dumb One Gaming stop the Drake going?
Well, Paddlestar is going to do a lot of AoE damage here as the teleport is flying in already from Dumb One Gaming. Spirit very, very low. In fact, the entire backline is struggling, and Jelly by himself has only the ultimate to keep him alive, and now the poke is reigning supreme. Dumb One bouncing forward, picking up kills left, right, and center, and a freak of freaks. They couldn't actually make the play happen.
They got their cake and ate it too. They get top lane turret. They can't stop the Rift Herald re-engage.
Yeah, that's another bot to come in, but that's just Spirit delivering his life over. A Devourer's already available from Hoyt. And Keen underneath his turret. I'm still not sure whether he's even safe as Nugger is the one tanking things up. But the corrosive charge is not going to land. And Keen goes golden to see his own death. Exactly, and they can also set up to try and get these picks so effectively as well. Gaming Spell Shield already on cooldown. Spirit, he was here for a moment, but he's going to be taken down very quickly. True Shot Barrage is going to soften up so many of these members, and the Trouble Bubble lands onto Aiming as well. They can't quite get over and finish him off. Oh, I spoke too soon. Top lane 1v1 and 2v2.
But if we come away saying, isn't Keen pretty good? Otherwise, whoopsie. Speaking of whoopsies.
Yeah, speaking of whoopsies indeed, as they'll take down the turret and the Sivir so easily. Yeah, exactly right. And Scouting Redemption comes in, and the Baron has almost entire vision for Dumb One. Keen wants to start off a fight, though, as Hoyt might actually just be taken out, and it is. Miasma in a great position. And Predator is on cooldown there as well. We've got Righteous Glory to get Keen in there, but True Shot Barrage is going to tag him up first, and they're just going to take down this Baron and now turn into the team fight. Trouble Bubble doesn't land. And Dumb One Gaming looking just to try and get out of there. They're making the consistent play, and Hoyt has the Devourer to deny the Trouble Bubble. Rather than anything else, two inhibitors seems to be enough here for Dumb One as they're taking down Nexus turrets now. This one very, very close. The next will surely follow swiftly as the Paddle Stars just make sure everyone doesn't have a health bar, and Punch gets the kickback. That was so sexy. As Spirit tries to do what he can, but he just can't get the work done. Shoemaker coming on forward. He's so incredibly fast. As Noggery in the front line, he's got the GA, and a freak of freaks is only Keen watching on in horror as once again the Nexus is going to be taken down. This is the Dumb One that we wanted after week one, and finally we're going to see it against the Afrika Freaks.
The amount of swagger that they showed in this game, they were on fleek as a squad, and they didn't even need the man himself, who will play in our second series of the night.